All right, good afternoon, wherever you may find yourself. This is Ebenezer Sari. Welcome back to my channel. So on my screen is a PowerPoint presentation cover page. So this is what one or anybody can do real quick. If say you are in a hurry and you need to pull up something interesting as your cover page for your slide. So I'm just gonna go through it, how I was able to do this, and then you tag along with me, and then I believe it will be interesting. So I made it out of Microsoft PowerPoint. This is the professional edition 2019, and then with a picture that I got online of the secondee runabout, an interesting fish. As you can see, when you are this edifice is close to the naval base, a second day. So stay along with me and let's complete this. All right, so what I'm gonna do is to get a new slide. I'm just gonna get rid of this so that we can start all over again and see how it was done. So I have a blank slide, and what I need to do next is to go to the view and then go to slide master. I'll hit slide master. I want something brand new. I can delete this. I don't need it. And delete this as well. I just leave it as is, and then get rid of the date and the footer. Okay, so what I'll do next is to get go to insert and get some shapes, right? So I'm just gonna do just create some rectangles, four of them actually. So this is the first. What I'll do is to hit hold down control and then just move a copy of it up here. Okay, perfect. I'll still hold down control this time. As I move my mouse, I'll just hold down shift as well so that I can it's moving two of them because they are selected, right? So I want to move only this one, so I'll hold down control, and as I move, I'll hold down shift. What it does is that it's aligns to the top here what I have already have for the first one, right? So I'll try and then make another copy of this tall one. Hold down control. As I move, I hold down shift. I think they are all far off, so what I can do is that just bring them in a bit. Okay, and you see they are not distributed evenly, so that what I can do is that I'll select all by hitting control A, and then on my align tab, alright, finally I got it. I got them to align horizontally. So what I'm going to do next is to get a picture placeholder in these shapes so that when I select a picture, it will fill these spaces, right? So what I'll do is next is to still hit Control A to select all of them. I need to hold down shift to deselect this one or move it away or even delete it. I don't need it to be part of it. So just control A, and this time around what I'm gonna do is that I'll go to format, make shapes, and then get these in a union, right? So they are together. So I can move them. together. I'll leave it as it is now, and then still go on my slide master and then do an insert placeholder, and I click picture. I'll draw a picture placeholder over all these selections, right? And then make sure that that picture placeholder is sent to the back. Okay, all right. So now, with the help of my shift key, I'll select the picture placeholder and then the shapes that I put together, and then still go to merge shapes and then do intercept. Perfect. Okay, so this is my slide. I can rename it. My layout, I'll name it Even Shape Layout. So if you're able to get to this point, it means 70% of your work is done. So you rename it, and then you close your slide master. You go on your page, go to layout, and then look for a Ben layout. Where is it? All right, you can also get it from here. You can just go to layout here, a Ben shape layout. Perfect. Now you have your shape in a placeholder fashion. So you just click pictures and look out for the picture that you want to set. Skadoosh, your work is done. All right, so what I'm going to do next is to just add the test. As you can see, the second D, Takoradi, Ghana's only twin city. Still going to insert, and then I'm just going to pull out some text boxes and then just type. So here I'm just going to type second D Takoradi. Perfect. I will triple click all of them. All right, on the test. So like three, and all of them will be selected. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna choose a particular font. I like using Lato. Of late, Railway, a test font that you can get free from the internet. It's what I've been using. I'll leave a link to these free fonts, Lato and then Railway, so you can select them. So I have Railway, semi bold. I'll select it. Okay, and then I'll leave it as is. So what I'm gonna do is I'll just bring it in a bit closer. All right, what I'm gonna do is that I'll leave the second D black as the font is, or the color of the font is. And but the Takoradi is quite interesting. So what I would do is that I'll select the Takoradi by double click, and then under the test team font, I'll just pick my eyedropper, and I'm going to select this color here. Interesting. So I got a second D Takoradi. I'll triple click, and then I'll make the test a bit loose, and then just stretch it a bit. Perfect. All right. So next is to add the Ghana's only twin city. So that one too, I'll just go to insert. Insert, and then pull up my text box and just do a text box. I'm gonna type Ghana's only Twin City. Okay, triple click to select all. What font am I gonna use? Let me use Lato. All right, and then just increase the font. All right, easy peasy lemon squeezy. So what I'm gonna do is to move it up a bit so it aligns to the left, and then I think I'll move it up a bit here at this side. I'm okay. Triple click to select all the text, go to the font color, and then choose the eyedropper tool again. And this time around, I'm just going to capture the color of the roof here with my eyedropper tool. Boom, I'm done. Okay. All right, and then I think the last thing that I need to do is to get this interesting line or shape at the edge. So let's do that and then complete it. I think I need to move this in a bit as well as this one. Okay. All right, so what I'm going to do next is to go home and just select a tool that is called the freeform shape, right? So I'm just going to start clicking. Sorry about that. I need to hit escape and then delete. I'm still gonna take the freeform shape. Hold on, shift. No, I didn't get it quite well. Still learning to how to perfect this, but seems the freeform too doesn't like me that much. Okay, so let's see if we can get another. It's been too hard living. We can use a connector elbow. Doesn't matter. Doesn't seem to be working very well. I think the what works is still the freeform too, but we need to know how to handle it. Okay, I think you click once. You hold down shift so that it becomes a straight line. You click again to release it. Coming down, hold shift so that it's straight. All right, you come down a bit, and then under the seat, you click again. And you hold down, still holding down shift. You click once more. Okay, you double click and it releases. All right, so as you can see, I think it also has the same font. You can choose to have that same font or leave it as is, but you have to make it the line a bit thicker, the shape outline. So we just go to weight and then choose a weight that is a bit thicker. I think this will be all right. And then still on the ship outline, you can still pick up your eyedropper to select the color that will make it the color that you want from the picture, referencing the picture, right? And easy peasy lemon squeezy, I'm done. So let me know what you think, if you have other means of creating these interesting cover pages for your slides, let me know. Other than that, please subscribe. And then like the video. Still need some chiquentos, so numbers is very necessary for me as of now. Thank you so much for being part of this. Let's catch up later. Bye.